See the line where the sky meets the sea? It's got uranium in it. Hey there, Drifters. Julian here for DNews. There was a time, just after the Second World War, when atomic power held the promise of limitless energy for the future. It's never lived up to the promise, though, partly because nuclear power has something of an image problem, but also because that limitless source of power isn't limitless, at least not the way we get it now, mining the Earth for uranium. With that in mind, researchers at Stanford University have developed a new way to extract uranium from seawater, bringing us closer to nuclear power that can sustain us for 10,000 years. The idea is not a new one. Uranium makes up a teeny percentage of the particles in the ocean, about 3 parts per billion, or roughly the equivalent of a grain of salt dissolved in a liter of water. The thing about the ocean is there's a whole lot of it, about 1.3 sextillion liters, or 13 with 20 zeros after it. That's a whole lot of uranium just drifting around when it could be powering your fridge. So since the 90s, Japan has been developing methods to pull it out of the water, with the United States and China following suit. Uranium exists in water bonded to 2 oxygen atoms in a molecule called uranyl. Try and be mature about the name, guys. Uranyl has a positive charge, so previous methods of extraction took advantage of this. To capture the uranyl, long strands of plastic covered in a chemical with a negative charge called amidoxime were left underwater for a month, where they would passively soak up that uranium goodness. Then the strands would be brought to the surface, where an acid bath would free the uranyl and regenerate the fibers so they could be put back in the ocean and used again. It's literally rinse and repeat. So far, so amazing. But the problem is the process hasn't been cost-effective enough. Even with serious improvements in the last 5 years that have reduced the cost of uranium extraction by a factor of 4, this method still produces uranium at the cost of about $440 per kilogram. The current method of finding a big deposit of uranium and then scooping it out of the earth is much more cost-effective, yielding uranium for anywhere from $22 to $260 per kilo. The new method developed by Stanford should drop prices even further. It works by combining amidoxime with carbon nanoparticles and applying pulses of electricity, drawing more charged uranyl ions to the fibers. By the time the old fibers with just amidoxime would be fully saturated, the new ones had soaked up 9 times more uranyl and still had room for more. This could make fuel for nuclear power truly limitless and much more accessible. It's estimated that we can only mine uranium from the Earth for about another 100 years before we've used it up, and the countries with significant reserves are Australia, Canada, Kazakhstan, and Russia. Meanwhile, since the ocean is so huge and it's constantly dissolving rocks that release more uranium into the water, the ocean's supply can meet global energy demands for 10,000 years, and the ocean is accessible to anyone with a coastline. That's why this new method developed at Stanford is so exciting. It brings limitless nuclear power a step closer to reality. Nuclear power still has other hurdles, like waste disposal and a serious public image problem. But if we're going to shift away from CO2-emitting energy sources like coal and natural gas, we're still going to need something that can be turned on and off to meet changing demands. Nuclear power can do just that, and the oceans can sustain it far into the future. You may be surprised to learn that you've gone swimming with uranium if you've ever taken a dip in the ocean. Sometimes radiation isn't as scary as we make it out to be, like the radiation from the Fukushima disaster. Trace has thoughts on that here. So, do you think this is the future of nuclear power? Are you more a thorium diehard? Or does nuclear just scare the pants off you? Let us know in the comments, subscribe for more, and I'll see you next time on DNews.